everybody, welcome back to a very special edition of Nintendo Treehouse Live featuring Splatoon 3. They want to do that. All right, and I'm here with Taryn.
Hello.
And our very own Treehouse Squid Lab researcher, Dutch.
Hi. Dutch.
All right. So what we're going to do now is we actually wanted to show off some of our multiplayer stuff. Now, before we start, I just wanted to do a little bit of a housekeeping to just let everybody know that this is a special build that we're playing on. We're actually not going to get right into multiplayer, but we did want to show you some elements to focus on that because there's a lot of really great stuff. And again, just to let everybody know, this game's coming out on September 9th, so just a little thing to keep in mind. All right, now, so Splatoon 3, let's see what we got first. I think we're going to show off a Splash-O-Matic. So Dutch?
Yeah, let's
what
see.
What is a Splash-O-Matic?
So the Splash-O-Matic is in the shooter class of weapons, which is kind of, it's kind of like the bread and butter of the Splatoon series. It's like your well-rounded, versatile weapon. You can see it's just got your classic rapid fire. It's got decent range. You're pretty much going to be able to do it all with this weapon. And we should also mention that weapons come in sets in Splatoon. So you can kind of see in the upper right-hand corner, I have a sub-weapon as well. In this case, that's the burst bombs. It looks like this. And throw that against the wall there. So you can see it just kind of explodes on impact.
Which is great. It's probably my favorite sub.
It's really useful.
Is it?
Yeah.
I like the autos because they just find, I guess we'll see that soon. No spoilers, but they find your enemy so you don't have to.
And the most exciting thing about this set for me is the crab tank. We can see that's my special weapon in that upper right-hand corner. It's kind of shimmering there, so that means it's ready to go. So let's take a look. Here it is.
This looks so good.
It's so dangerous.
Love that one. And actually, I'm going to go ahead and clean up here so I can get that again. Because the crab tank actually has two different attacks. So that was the first one that's kind of like a rapid fire machine gun that really has very good range as well. And then there's another attack. It's kind of like this big shell that has an area of effect here.
Great area of effect. I really like using that one a lot. One thing to note, too, to point out for those who are watching at home is we're actually in the new multiplayer lobby. This is the test range side of things. So if you're wondering, like, whoa, what is this? This is a brand new feature to Splatoon 3. It's really, really cool. It allows you to, well, test your weapons in the range.
Yeah, it's actually fun, and it is a big change from Splatoon 2, where now the lobby is like a physical space where you can be practicing while you're waiting for a match, or I think we saw in the Direct that you'll see kind of holographic ghosts of your friends in the lobby if they're online. So it's kind of a cool new hub for the multiplayer battles. Let's take a look around, kind of see this space here.
Yeah. It looks so good.
Actually, we haven't showed off the Squid Surge and Roll, which is something we might want to do.
Yeah. And that is a fun new addition to Splatoon 3 as well. And to show that off, let's see. So the squid roll, typically, you know, if you're going in one direction, you get kind of you have to slow down and kind of stop your momentum to get going in the other direction. But with this new mechanic here, you can turn on the dime and go in the opposite direction. So imagine maybe somebody's throwing a bomb in front of you. You can change direction really quickly, and it actually gives you a few frames of protection while you're doing that move.
All right, let's see this in action.
All right, yeah. So here's another toy that we've got in the lobby over here, which is the copy machine. So I'm going to go ahead and wake it up here. It's kind of vaguely threatening. So the copy machine here does it copies what I'm doing. So if I shoot, it shoots. It throws bombs when I throw bombs. And it tries to deflect blame onto his teammates. If I try to deflect blame onto my teammates, does everything that I do.
Dutch, when have you ever had to deflect blame?
Let's find out.
I've had some tough matches. All right, so I'm going to try to show off this new squid roll move that gives you that that couple frames of protection here. So if I'm rolling wrong, I see a bomb.
There you go.
Oh, well done. That is not
easy. Normally,
that would
be enough to splat you right there.
Got it in one.
But you kind of hear that like little like shimmery kind of sound that lets you know that you kind of got it out of there. Let me try one more.
All right. So then why, since we, look at you show off now.
I know.
So maybe we should move on to the next topic here. Squid Surge.
Yeah, Squid Surge. So that's another new mechanic for Splatoon 3, and that's going to help you get up walls. So if I get onto this wall and I charge it up, it's going to shoot me up and give me a little boost up there so I can kind of get the drop on people. So that's useful if you're, maybe you've got somebody camping out up here. You can come up here, do a little Squid Surge, and come down on it from above.
You're so accurate.
Yeah,
I always
miss
that. I tried practicing that a couple of times. I really love the move.
And that's the worst when you're like set up the move perfectly, and then you get to the up to the top there, and you're like, oh, missed it.
That's just gonna be so much more deadly.
Anyway, okay. Well, let's check out a different weapon. Yeah.
Yeah. I was gonna say let's check out the next one, which I believe is one of your favorites.
It is. Yeah. I have spent a lot of time with the carbon roller here, and actually, while we're here, I just want to show off one more kind of quality of life improvement here. You can sort the weapons by class, and you've got that up here, which
it's
is nice.
It's so good. I love that they added that.
Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and clean up here so we get some new territory here. So this is the carbon roller. This is a weapon in the roller class, and the way this class works is you've got an ink roller here, and if you press the attack button, it does kind of a horizontal splash like that. It's pretty short range, but it's pretty powerful as well. And if you hold it down, then you can run around with it on the ground and
mow people over.
That's great.
And this particular one, with most roller weapons, that's going to be a one-hit splat if you've got it rolling around on the ground. But this one trades a little bit of power for greater mobility, which I love because for me, my play style is really like getting up in people's faces, smashing them, and
look at them go.
Smashing people's faces. That's just game
style. Speaking
of
mobility, too, this one actually comes with the Zipcaster, which is
that's
really
true. Cool. Yeah. And one more point on the roller class. So you also have this, if you jump and attack, then you do kind of a vertical fling that gives you a little bit more range, but it's a narrower spread of ink, so you kind of have to be a little more accurate with it. But yeah, so let's check out the Zipcaster here, which is a brand new special for Splatoon 3. And I'm really excited about this one as somebody who spends a lot of time with a roller, which is short range and, you know, kind of get pinned down by people with longer range weapons a lot. So let's imagine maybe up on that tower there's somebody with a long range weapon kind of pinning me down back here. What the Zipcaster is going to do is going to let me zip around, cling to walls, and it's going to let me come up right on this person right there.
Oh, so good.
And you do have to be careful when you use it, though, because you might have seen there's a little marker. And when it ends, it sends you back to the place you started. So if you don't take care of business with it, and people see where you're going to land, they're going to come right there and be waiting for you.
Spot you.
Yeah, you'll land and be like, oh, that was not what I was expecting.
And the sub-weapon for this one as well, which you can see here, is another one coming back from Splatoon 2 is the Autobomb. You can kind of see the little ring shoots out when it lands, and that's going to detect the nearest enemy, walk over to it, and explode.
It's so awful. I mean, in the best possible way. If you're the one throwing it, it's just brilliant.
All right, so let's show this off in our first stage we wanted to display.
Wow, yeah, let's take a look.
So let's go ahead and cut away to that, and then we're going to go to our first stage that we wanted to show.
And we've got the Splatoon 3 Splatfest world premiere coming up this weekend. So we wanted to take a look at some of the stages that will be in the rotation.
And if you've never heard of Splatfest before, it's a mode where you play Turf War and Tricolor Turf War. But first, you actually get to vote on three different choices, depending if, in this case, you want to be Rock, Paper, or Scissors. I think I'm gonna go for scissors. No, wait, I'm paper.
No, I'm scissors. We've had this discussion already.
I got rock. That's all I know. I'm rock.
This happens every time. I'm scissors.
No, but I'm gonna be scissors.
What? We're gonna be on the same team. I guess that could be fun too. That can be fun. I'd rather not get splatted by you. I splat with you. So
that's actually a really good point too. I'm glad you brought that up, Taryn, too. It's just for those who don't know at home, you definitely want to vote for the same thing if you won't be on the same team.
Yes.
Just a little pro
good
tip.
Point.
All right, so here we are in Scorch Gorge. So take it away, Dutch.
Yeah, so it's kind of I'm really looking forward to this weekend because this is kind of eerie right here. It's like there's nobody here. This is deserted. I'm excited to see some people get in here and play around. So this is kind of keeping in the theme with Splatoon 3, which is chaos, right? So we've got this kind of gritty, rusted out, worn down, rugged terrain here. And a couple of jellyfish up there taking
casual
shots, I guess.
Jellies. Just yeah, on so the rocks.
Kind of a canyon.
That feels like a desert.
Kind of, yeah.
Either way.
And then I'll go ahead and open up the turf map here so you can see the layout of the stage. And so I'm thinking that for this particular stage, it's all going to be about this middle tower here. Because that controls the access to each side. So that's the only way you're going to get into the other team's base. So let's come up here.
Yeah, I feel
which is Dutch's favorite thing. Sorry.
It's all about, I think, defending this middle and keeping it controlled.
Right. Mm-hmm. So if you want to get into the other base, you're going to have to come up here and go along this catwalk, which leaves you kind of exposed from below. If you go into squid form, you see you drop right through it.
Yes. Well, there we go.
Yeah. And then once you're over here, then you can get back this way and cause trouble.
But now that you have the Zipcaster, though.
Yeah. So for, I think the Zipcaster is going to be great for maybe taking control of that middle area. So you can see, imagine somebody's controlling that and dominating you from the center post there. So what are we going to do? Let's get the Zipcaster here and fly right over here. Come up this way.
It attaches to surfaces that you wouldn't normally be able to ink, correct? Did we already
correct.
Mention that?
That's a great point.
So powerful.
it's really, really great. It's all about kind of moving in a triangle momentum. Momentum. What was that word?
Triangle movement.
And that
with
combination
momentum.
Of the good range and being able to stick to every surface really lets you kind of zip around the stage and get behind enemy lines.
I imagine being unpleasantly surprised by thinking you're safe in one area,
yeah,
and then
exactly.
So Dutch comes winging in with his carbon roller and Zipcaster.
And of course, there are many other special weapons that you'll get using, depending on the weapons that you have. But
yeah, well, let's hop back and take a look at a couple other, sets here. So let's look at Scorch Gorge, which is going to be in the rotation this weekend. And let's hop back in.
Okay. So time to show off something a little different.
Yeah, so you're taking a look at a shooter class weapon, the Splash-O-Matic. That was the first one we saw. And we saw the carbon roller in the roller class. Let's take another look at
Splat Charger.
The Splat Charger.
Demetrius's favorite, right? Just kidding.
I really like this weapon. I think it's great fun. I'm just not the best at you.
So this is your classic long-range kind of sniper-style weapon. You can see the range on this one compared to the other ones.
That charge up is so satisfying.
Yeah, and that sound that it makes. So this is what it sounds like normally if you're missing. But
if you're missing, I feel targeted by that comment.
It's cool, though. I always appreciate seeing someone on my team using this weapon. I'm always just in awe.
I mean, when you get a good charger on your team, it's like a relief. Because this is really for like the crafty, skilled, patient, backline style player.
People who can hang out in the back and just take people down, help defend.
What's the sub and special for this one?
Yeah, so the sub for this one is the Splat Bomb, which kind of this pyramid-shaped one. You throw it out, and after it settles on the ground for like a second, it'll explode. And then, let's go back to the copy machine, and I can show off the special here. So this is another special that's brand new for Splatoon 3.
This is so good. This is probably my personal favorite.
Over the crab tank?
The crab tank is great, but this is so good. I think it's going to catch a lot of people off guard with
the
amount of ink you can use if you use it correctly.
All right, so this is the ink vac, and what it's going to do is basically suck up any ink that's being fired at me. And then I can shoot it back, and it'll create a big explosion. So this is sucking up all the ink that the copy machine is shooting. I'm gonna launch it back that way.
Boom!
You can see the range on that too.
It's so good.
Like the range, I shot that from like back here. It goes all the way, basically all the way across the test range here. We should try that one more time.
I was like, maybe we should show that without powering it up, just to kind of give people an idea of what it's like. Yeah, it looks good. There we go. And did we explain, just in case somebody knows, what Dutch is doing right now is he's actually inking the ground, so he's building up his special meter that you see on the top right-hand screen.
Exactly.
So just for those who are new or wondering, why is he doing that?
Why are just randomly firing on the ground?
Name of the game is
as long as I'm standing, in front, I'm sucking up all that ink. So I'm not getting damaged by it. It's kind of absorbing it. But if you keep getting hit after it's full, that will take you out. So you have to be careful in timing it. So
don't let the coffee machine splat you.
He was gonna do it.
I was looking a little bit dicey there for a second.
Another thing that's back from Splatoon 2 is storing your charge, and then you can swim in the ink for a couple seconds before popping back out and releasing that entire charge shot.
Oh yeah, I always forget about that. So yeah, you're charging it, and then you swim, and then you recover. Okay, yeah, that looks great. Yeah. All right, so why don't we show off and go to the second stage we want to show, which is Eel Tail Alley. So why don't cut away from this, and we'll show that off.
Wait, so Dutch, what team were you then? Since both Team Scissors.
I'm Team Rock.
Yeah, you are still Team
Rock. Yeah, don't overthink it.
All right, Team Paper it is.
I feel like you two were fighting over paper initially, and so now you've just completely changed sides, Demetrius.
I mean, I'm a fan of Big Man.
So. That's fair, yes. It's not really a choice of Scissors, it's Big Man.
And that's probably why I can't help it.
I don't blame you.
Okay. So we're going into Eel Tail Alley, and this is a different type of stage. Oh, you know, we just saw kind of that rugged desert that Dutch was pointing out, but this is more of like a cityscape feel to it.
Yeah, right off the bat, it's definitely a different feel. Let's take a look around here.
Actually, one thing we should point out too, we haven't mentioned yet, was you just spawning right there, and that was one of the new features as well.
Exactly, yeah. So you spawn actually from the air, and you can choose your landing spot as opposed to always spawning in the same spot. That really makes it a little more dynamic. You know, maybe you're getting pinned down in your base, but you can actually choose where to land so that you can kind of, you know, approach your opponents from a different angle.
It's one of the three new techniques, with the other one being Squid Surge and Squid Roll.
And Squid Spawn. I'm seeing a pattern with these names, perhaps.
They're great
names. I don't want to be too obvious about it, but.
Let's take a look at the turf map here. We see this is Eel Tail Alley, and it really does look like an alley. You know, it's kind of long and narrow.
And like an eel.
Like an eel.
Oh.
Why am I getting hungry?
What? Sushi later?
Yeah, it sounds good.
So if I'm playing a charger on this map, I think it's going to be all about this catwalk up here. I think this is where I'm going to be living. And that's because I can get, you know, the high ground to kind of control this area down here as the other team comes up the middle. Maybe if I want to get really aggressive, I might come all the way up to this front area and be looking down here, clear out the pigeons.
Oh, Dutch, why? Every time, Dutch.
Poor pigeon.
Pigeon never did anything to you.
Yeah, this spot right here gives me access. You know, I got a clear shot.
It's you.
At all these areas where the other team might come out.
I think there will be a lot of fighting below, too, as well. And I feel like the ink vac will be really great because you'll be able to kind of push the line, push the advance of your team using that special.
Exactly, yeah. You drop down here, soak up all the ink that everybody's shooting at you. It takes a while to charge when there's no ink.
Just a little.
The explosion's a bit smaller, too.
This is why I'm so excited for this weekend, though, because, you know, like, we've been messing around with this game a little bit, but I'm really excited to get in there with other people and, you know, try out all my moves.
Just play nicely with them, Dutch.
When there's nobody against me. But.
If you see the name Dutch on the opposing team, be afraid, or amazed, or impressed. All of the above are the correct responses.
All right, so you got a chance to see the Splat Charger and Eel Tail Alley. Let's go ahead and move back to the lobby because we have one more thing to show. So we're going to cut to that. gave us
only the best thing to show.
I can't wait. I think this is going to be it's just such a cool feature. And what we're talking about is we're going to actually show you 1 second the lockers. And lockers are just something I think a lot of people are wanting, you know, yeah. this customization option of showing off, you know, your own unique style, which the Splatoon series has always had. So just being able to, you know, expand on that, I think it's wonderful.
Exactly. And this is, you know, it's all connected to this physical space in the lobby here.
So that's quit delaying. We want lockers now.
All right, so
although we know
locker.
What's going to happen to
I know.
Which I have
maybe he'll be good this time.
Maybe. So with these these are your personal lockers, and what you can do is you can actually add your weapons and even some items that you get from Hotlantis. Mm-hmm. That's one of the new stores in this game. It's really cool. On top of that, oh, here Dutch goes.
Here it is again.
Organizing.
We can't
man,
ever
I never
go without
see
it.
Your closet at home.
Just remember how perfect this was when we first showed it.
It was in perfect harmony, which is also
the name.
Also the name. Wow. Now you can put the cups upside down.
Yes. The dust gets in it and stuff, so I don't.
I mean.
Also, one thing to note is you can, you have stickers. You can actually even change the color of your locker. There's a lot of stuff to add, which is going to be really, really, really cool. One other thing, too, to point out. Oh, look.
What are you doing? Dutch. And you can see other people's lockers. So if you see one that looks something like this in your travels,
hate mail this way.
It might be Dutch's.
Oh, man. All right, so there's one other thing, too, we want to quickly show is the splash tags, which is another really cool feature that is also new to the game. All right, put that mess away.
You've done enough.
So on the left-hand side of the screen, as you'll see, it says Splatlandian Youth Player 1. This is actually the splat tags where you could normally would have your name, and you can have different banners, badges, and titles. Mm. You obviously wouldn't just be Player 1. We just use
I
that
mean, you could
reference.
Be if you
you
want.
If you want to.
That's you.
Yeah.
You are player. You are number one. Player 1.
You know, you're not wrong. But there's a lot of cool stuff. And one thing to note, too, is with the lockers and even the splash tags that there will be some season catalogs that come. So expect to have new items to be able to put into your locker, new splash tag stuff, even some new weapons. So really cool stuff, or additional weapons, I should say. So really, really cool stuff coming as well. All right, so with that, we took a look at the lockers and the splash tag. I have one more thing I wanted to show. And I got it down here, so just give me a moment to pick it up, because I don't want to drop it.
Hey.
And that is the special edition Splatoon 3 Nintendo Switch OLED. Super cool. It's actually out in stores August 26th, so about now you could go check it out. But we just want to show that off, and let me actually take this out right here and show you what the actual system looks like, too, outside of its dock. It's got this super, super cool design here. I'm gonna move a little back and forth so you can see that cool little design shimmering across.
Yeah.
And then one more thing I have here. I'll pick this one up. This is the Splatoon 3 Pro Controller as well. Now, this one comes out September 9th, so it's out on launch day, but we just wanted to show you how cool that looks with the two different colors and the cool design on it.
It's so good.
It looks awesome.
Yes. I'm going to end up buying one, and I won't regret it at all.
Oh, these are super cool. Okay, so with that being said, that is it for Splatoon 3 today. One more time, just to remind everybody at home that Splatoon 3 Splatfest World Premiere is going to be out on the eShops now. But don't go anywhere. We got some Harvestella up next. We'll see you soon. Thanks.